Good morning. Please stand.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Today you'll notice that I am dressed in white. I am vested in white. We celebrate today Saint Scholastica, who lived about 1,500 years ago. And we celebrate something really cool about her, and that is that she had the heart of a child. She had a brother. And one time when she was visiting her brother, she prayed that the visit would not end, and there was this huge storm that came, and they were forced together to be together for even more time. She loved to spend time with God and with family. And so for those times when we have not loved God or family or friends as we should, we ask the Lord for his pardon and for his forgiveness.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. As we celebrate anew the memorial of the Virgin Saint Scholastica, we pray, O Lord, that following her example, we may serve you with pure love and happily receive what comes from loving you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. At the time when the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, while as yet there was no field shrub on earth, and no grass of the field had sprouted, for the Lord God had sent no rain upon the earth, and there was no man to till the soil, but a stream was welling up out of the earth and was watering all the surface of the ground. The Lord God formed man out of the clay of the ground and blew into his nostrils the breath of life, so that man became a living being. Then the Lord God planted a garden in Eden in the east, and he placed there the man whom he had formed. Out of the ground the Lord God made various trees grow that were delightful to look at and good for food, with the tree of life in the middle of the garden and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. The Lord God then took the man and settled him in the Garden of Eden to cultivate and care for it. The Lord God gave man this order: "You are free to eat from any of the trees of the garden, except the tree of knowledge of good and evil. From that tree you shall not eat. The moment you eat from it, you are surely doomed to die." The word of the Lord. You are clothed with majesty and glory, robed in light as with a cloak.
Oh, bless the Lord, my soul.
All creatures look to you to give them food in due time. When you give it to them, they gather it. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things.
Oh, bless the Lord, my soul.
If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. From the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the crowd again and said to them, "Hear me, all of you, and understand. Nothing that enters one from outside can defile that person, but the things that come from within are what defile." When he got home away from the crowd, his disciples questioned him about the parable. He said to them, "Are even you likewise without understanding? Do you not realize that everything that goes into a person from outside cannot defile, since it enters not the heart, but the stomach, and passes out into the latrine?" Thus he declared all foods clean. But what comes out of the man, that is what defiles him. And from within the man, from his heart, come evil thoughts: unchastity, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, lasciviousness, envy, blasphemy, arrogance, and folly. All of these evils come within, and they defile. The Gospel of the Lord.
I don't care how old you might be, You're never too old for one movie that we often see during the Christmas season, and that is the movie Elf. Many who have seen the movie Elf love it because Buddy has these incredibly great qualities. He's got this innocence. He has this goodness. He wants what's best for people. He loves to play, to sing, to dance, to cut out all kinds of ornaments and decorate. He loves to compliment others. It sounds like how God created humanity to be. Many times, to be old, to be grown up, we think that we have to stop being childlike. And we will see in the movie The Elf, we will see other people tell Buddy, the other elves, gosh, he won't just grow up. We'll see his dad and his stepbrother say, he's just so childish, why can't he grow up? People whom he will work with will say, what's going on? Won't he just grow up? But his innocence, his joy, and his goodness would be contagious. And he would touch so many people's lives in that movie, including his stepbrother and his father. We all love watching the movie Elf simply because of that goodness that Buddy has. I love to walk through the school. Oftentimes when I walk through the school, I see first grade who's in front of me. Sometimes I'll see you skipping. I'll see you singing. I'll see you dancing. I'll see you twirling. I'll see you on the swings, doing cartwheels, chasing each other, playing patty cakes. There will be smiling and laughing. There's always dreaming, imagining. There's creating something. Many minds right now might be wandering in your own childhood memories of doing something similar. There's a pure, there's a raw, there's a joy that children have. There's a goodness that comes out. You're always in the moment, just ready to enjoy those around you and what's going on. They're comfortable with who they are. They don't know that they're supposed to be someone different. They don't know how to be someone different. Children's hearts sing the psalm of today. Bless the Lord, my soul. There's a deep trust that you have in the Lord. Don't ever lose that. There's an eagerness to learn and to recognize God. There's an eagerness to share joy with others. Sometimes when we get in middle school, maybe seventh, eighth grade, there can be this temptation that we have to become someone different, that we have to grow up, that we can't be childlike anymore. Sometimes we'll find ourselves expressing this if we have younger siblings. We'll say, stop being so childish, stop doing that. I don't want to do that anymore, I'm not a child. I'm too cool for that innocence that might be there, yet that's exactly what we want and who we want to be. Jesus always reminds us the kingdom of God belongs to children. To have qualities like Buddy the Elf, to let our hearts sing that refrain, bless the Lord, my soul, and we do that through our innocence, through our goodness, through wanting the best for people, through loving to play and sing and dance, to compliment others, and to always recognize and learn about our God. Amen. With joyful hearts, we present our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father.
That the church may continue to be sanctified and strengthened through the transforming grace of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may look graciously upon all who desire and strive for purity of heart for the sake of their salvation, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have experienced violence or hatred of any kind may be consoled by the peace and healing of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hearts of those gathered here may be purified from every evil, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we would take the opportunity to observe Black History Month to honor the achievements, contributions, and experiences of Black Americans in United States history, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may live forever in God's presence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Dale Smith, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we each pause to offer the Lord those prayers and petitions which we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, help us to be good and true and loving. Help us to be your children. Hear and answer all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we proclaim your wonders, O Lord, in the Virgin Blessed Scholastica, we humbly implore your majesty that as her merits are pleasing to you, so too our dutiful service may find favor in your sight through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Bishop, and all the clergy and people, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Scholastico's feast day we celebrate today, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low?
Let us pray. Renewed by partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of the blessed Saint Scholastica, hearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone through Christ our Lord. Amen. Today is also Focus 11, which is a time which 11th grade and those who are 11 years old in 6th grade have an opportunity to be talked to, discover vocations. And so we look forward to the day when first grade can experience that as well. It's a blessing to be with you during Mass. And we continue today to go out as children filled with joy. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.